Hitman, the next iteration in IO Interactive's franchise, will be released in the first week of December 2015 and will follow on from Hitman Absolution. Is this game a silent assassin or dead on arrival? Here's the real concerns. The new Hitman is a digital distributed only game, as confirmed by IGN and the developers, and will never see a physical release. That creates a problem because, let's be honest here, the PlayStation Store and the Xbox Store aren't the most reliable of online services, and you can bet your bottom dollar at least twice a week the store will be down for maintenance. Another problem occurs through the game's structure, as the game is incomplete at launch, and will see its story being worked on periodically throughout 2015 and well into 2016, with some missions only being active for 48-hour time periods, and the main problem here you could see a mile off. November and December are busy months for gamers. You have Star Wars Battlefront, Fallout 4, and Just Cause 3 to name a few. So say you don't pick up this game on launch day because it's buried under a sea of new indie releases on Steam, or the PlayStation Store is down, or to be completely honest, it doesn't get oversaturated or enough coverage like the other big games of that month. So it slips under the cracks, because I know right now, come November, and December, there'll be Star Wars posters as far as the eye can see. So Hitman will fade off into obscurity and become esoteric. And with it not being in the store, you won't see it as a game to pick up when you're out. But I digress. Let's get back to the point. If you don't pick up the game at launch, you'll miss out on a lot of its content and most likely a lot of its timed missions. This game should really take a few steps back first and think, because if they go with their plan, it's not going to be noticed when it comes out since the other big games were shrouded, and it won't get picked up by the casual gamer when they're out for their next game that catches their eye in GameStop. Because it's only a download, which is something not even Telltale does. You can buy The Walking Dead or Game of Thrones from a store. If I was IO Interactive, I would look closely at the Destiny model, or the Telltale one, and open up new avenues for all its loyal fans, because making this a download only thing will not be good for it. And as a fan of the series since Codename Agent 47, with the best being Blood Money in 2006, I would hate for that to happen. Also, a question to everyone: how many games do you know that you have in your Steam collection? And how many games did you need to delete on your PlayStation in order to install the next one? IO Interactive right now is not the best time to take the shot. But please let me know what you think of their marketing ideas below, and have a great day.